Windows Server Core is fast, secure, and reliable. Microsoft has removed the graphical user interfaces from Windows and called it Windows Core. This will allow us to have a lighter version of Windows with less surface for attacks. But how do we configure a Windows Server Core? Once you log into a Windows Server Core, you are faced with one command prompt. You don't have any of those traditional Windows or interfaces that we are used to work with. Well, we have two options for configuring and administering a Windows Server Core. Number one, if you're like me, comfortable with PowerShell, you can configure everything and manage your entire operating system with Windows PowerShell. But not everybody likes and enjoys working with PowerShell. Many people still prefer to use the graphical user interfaces. The other solution is to use another computer with the graphical user interface and use remote management. But we have to enable the remote management first and do a little bit of pre-configuration before we can start remote management. My name is Ali, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to configure your Windows Server Core and set up all the post-installation configurations. Join me on this video to take a look at SCONFIG, which is a tool we use for configuring a Windows Server Core. At the command prompt, type SCONFIG and hit enter. SystemConfig is a tool designed to complete the post-installation steps in a semi-graphical and interactive manner. Once the tool is loaded, you will notice there are 15 sets of commands categorized in 4 sections. You can see they are very self-descriptive. First 4 are for joining the server to the domain, renaming the computer, adding a new local administrator user, and enabling or disabling the remote management. Next 3 options are for Windows update behavior and remote desktop settings. Options 8 to 11 are some generic settings such as IP, date and time, telemetry setting, and Windows activations. The last 4 options are logout, restart, and shutting down the server. Or you can quit the tool and go back to the command prompt. Please note that some of these menus have submenus as well. Let's take a look at some of these. In order to use any of the menus, you just need to type in the number of the menu that you would like to use and follow the instructions. Let's start with setting IP configurations. Type 8 and hit enter. System will show a list of all network adapters. If you have multiple network adapters, type in the index number of the network adapter you want to change and hit enter. You now have 4 submenus. Number 1 allows you to check and assign a new IP address. Number 2 allows you to check and set your DNS preferences. 3 clears your DNS server setting. And 4 brings you back to the main menu. Now, let's join the server to the domain. For that, type 1 and hit enter. Type D for joining your server to the domain, W for workstation, and hit enter without typing any letters to cancel out. By typing D and pressing enter, you will be prompted for the domain name. Enter your domain name and hit enter. Then enter your username. System will open another page and ask for entering your password. Enter your password and hit enter. Please note, the system will not display the characters as you type them. Once your server is joined to the domain, system will ask you if you would like to rename the computer before restarting. Click no and continue to the restart. Now, let's log into another server and add this core server to the server manager for some remote management tasks. On your destination server, open the server manager page and select Add Other Servers to Manage. In the open dialog, you can find your server through Active Directory search, DNS name, or if you have a list of servers to manage, you can simply import them. Type in your server's name and hit the search icon. From the list, select your server and hit the right arrow icon to add the selected server and click OK. Wait a few minutes and you'll see more settings showing up in your server manager. On the left menu, click on All Servers to see the list of servers you can control remotely. From now on, you can manage your server core from this console as if you're logged in locally. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel for more videos like this. Make sure to hit the bell icon to be notified when the new content is released. Also, leave a comment in the comment section down below and let me know what other subjects would you like to learn. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you on the next video.